Hello, Internet. Zach here, and welcome back to Collecting the Elements. I finally have my table back in my lab, away from the cat. Sorry, Annabelle. And all of my samples are back, hanging up in it where they belong. So it's time to add another one. Element number 77, iridium. Iridium is the second densest metal known to science, weighing in at 22.5 grams per cubic centimeter, almost 22.6. It's twice as dense as lead, and quite a bit denser even than gold. So one might call it a heavy metal. Iridium is one of the many silvery gray metals on the periodic table. It's also a particularly hard and particularly brittle metal, much like tungsten. It finds use wherever extreme resistance to corrosion is necessary at high temperatures. For example, in crucibles used in the semiconductor industry to grow very pure crystals, in the chloralkali process for making chlorine gas, and also in the tips of automotive spark plugs, where it has to resist not only making a spark, but also all of the craziness that goes on with the combustion in the cylinder. Iridium is also famous for its presence in the layer of rock that divides the Cretaceous period from the Tertiary period. This is about 66 million years ago. The presence of elevated levels of iridium in this layer of rock pointed to the impact of a 6-mile-wide meteor that slammed into the Yucatan Peninsula and killed off all of the non-avian dinosaurs. So without further ado and without killing any more dinosaurs, I'm going to be extracting iridium from some spark plugs. The other day, a friend of mine replaced the spark plugs in her car. These are the old ones. And I checked online. The tips right here are made of iridium. And the little metal discs down here on the ground prong are made of platinum. When I get set up at the homestead, I'll have a much better source of platinum available for element samples. So from these, I intend to just harvest the iridium. The first step in getting the iridium out of the spark plugs is going to be to bend this ground tab out of the way. Pry on this central terminal here. There we go. Think. Slide the ceramic sleeve off. And then bend the metal central pin back and forth until it breaks off. There we go. That little tip right there is all the iridium that's in this. The rest is copper and probably nickel. To separate the iridium on here from the other metals, I'm going to use electrolysis. So here's a 12-volt power brick I'll be using to power the process, and an extension cord. And I'll be connecting the spark plug tip to the positive electrode. And to the negative electrode, I'll be attaching a piece of copper wire. Right now, I just have distilled water in the bowl here to make it more conductive and to help dissolve away the unwanted metals, adding just a little bit of sulfuric acid. Stir that up a bit. Now when I dip the positive terminal in, the copper, nickel, and everything that's not iridium is going to start dissolving. The iridium is not going to dissolve, it's just basically going to sit there and do nothing. So eventually, when all of the stuff that isn't iridium gets done dissolving, the piece of iridium will just fall off and sink to the bottom of the container. Okay, now I have it set up so it's nice and balanced and the spark plug tip isn't going to fall into the solution. And I'm just going to let that sit there and bubble. This has been running for about 10 minutes now, and already the solution is turning yellow from dissolved metals. And the spark plug tip is starting to very slowly dissolve. It's been just over 20 minutes, and while the piece of iridium hasn't fallen off yet, the metal holding it on has gotten really thin. It shouldn't be long now. It's been about half an hour. The iridium tip just dropped off of here. There it is. Tiny little speck right there. See if I can pick it up. Get most of the liquid out. And I'm gonna try to drop it on a paper towel. There it is. That little speck is a piece of solid iridium. And there it is in a test tube. Well, one down, seven to go. So iridium piece number six fell off. Six down, two more to go. Still waiting for the last one to fall off. There's the bit of iridium and the tiny bit of metal still holding it on. There it is. The final piece of iridium. And there are the eight tiny pieces of iridium in a test tube. Time to seal them up. So here it is. It's not much iridium, but it's there. I really hope it's not becoming a trend with element samples getting smaller and smaller as the elements get harder to obtain. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, hit the like button. If you want to see more, subscribe. If you know someone else who would enjoy this, hit share. And throw me a few coins on PayPal or Patreon, links in the description, to help me make more videos. Anyway, see you next time.